Hello, environmentalists. This is Ms. May Cutt, and it is May 26th, and I'm here to share with you the update for the final project in case you missed it earlier. So what you're looking at right now is the project overview, and I chose this because we have been on this journey together for a while, and you will never look at the world again with the same eyes that you had before taking this class. Some of you, it might be a subtle change. Some of you, it might be quite dramatic, but you will see the world now differently than you had before. And a lot of the news out there isn't great. Like, I get that. But there is a huge wave of people that are fighting to make things better. And I'm guessing that might have been part of the reason you got into this in the first place. So let's look at that. And the other thing to remember is what causes change, real change in our planet, on our Earth, isn't necessarily the science. It's the artists or the journalists or the politicians or the lobbyists or the lawyers or the, you know, high schoolers that stand up and speak out. Those are the people that can shift the needle and move people's hearts to make different choices. So let's find some ways to celebrate that and recognize the progress that we've made and those who are out there fighting the good fight. So just a quick overview, there are three main components to this project. The first one is the background information. So there's a couple different ways you can do it. You can watch the documentary, A Fierce Green Fire. So the links are here. So Fierce Green Fire, now you can either watch the whole documentary, and it's an hour and 40 minutes, and it is amazing, and you should watch it because it's amazing. Okay. If not, though, you can also look at, you can get a quick sense of it and who did what and the players by going through their timeline. So this is their timeline. You can kind of scroll down, and then they just really run through a lot of the big movements. They tie it into some cool components, and then you can also, you'll see over here there's this whole menu, and these are the different chapters from it, and you can click on one of these and it'll give you a little excerpt. You can watch a little 3 minute, 2 minute snippet from the documentary. So that's one way that you can get your background information. So that's our beginning, is the background. And the other way is to look at the biographies. So if you go in here, so you can do the documentary, you can look at the timeline, or you can look at these biographies. And these are all linked in the Schoology folders. Okay. And so these are just some like badass environmentalists you should know. So pick three of them that you think are cool. There's instructions here. You can follow those. You don't have to follow the instructions. These are guidelines. So do what feels right to you. Check out the ones you are thinking are interesting, or follow my guidelines, whatever works. Okay, that's the first part. And then you're sharing it with the class. That's the idea, like each one teach one in this regard. Like, so what did you take away from it? What did you learn from that? Please put that into the discussion post and then read some of them. So if you'll scroll down here, you'll see environmental movement, background discussion, share out. Share, okay? And read what some people said. So that's the first part. Second part is the project itself. And I'm gonna click on the brief descriptions. On my intro, there are longer descriptions you can look into. I will give you an example of one. But the three project formats are the superhero project, the art piece in the Beauceat Ocean Awareness Contest, or an Each One Teach One video. And for this, so the superhero, like I said, you're going to be seeing all these cool environmentalists that have done really amazing stuff. And You know, maybe you're inspired by someone. Maybe you think their story's interesting. And so learn a bit more about it and share it with us. You can present this in any format you choose. It could be art, it could be a presentation or PowerPoint, it could be a video, it could be... So have some fun with this, all right? The second one, the BOSEAT Ocean Awareness Contest, I'll show you the link in a minute. It is an amazing, amazing competition, contest, but really it's the sharing of beautiful expression that is meaningful and powerful and heartfelt. And you can do it, it encourages, you can do multimedia, you can do, of course, painting, and but you could do voice, you can music, you can do dance. So know that those are also options. And then the each one teach one, is there something you've learned in this class or that you want to learn that maybe you just haven't quite motivated yourself to do? Well, go do it and make a video of it and teach us about it. I will tell you, there is a student in your class who learned how to take a sweatshirt and convert it into very comfortable, stylish shorts. And that could be a video of how to recycle clothing. So keep that in mind, have some fun with it. Those are the three project ideas. If there's something else you want to do, just let me know. Like I said, this is guidelines. Okay, now let's see if I can get out of this one. Oops. Escape. Here we go. So those are the three project descriptions, the three kind of project formats. And then we will be submitting that right now and sharing them. Right now it's going to be a media folder. I'm not quite sure if that's what will work, but tentatively that's the format because I'd like you to be able to view each other's work and share yours and make comments and be like, hey, I learned something cool. It was interesting, or I thought that was really beautiful, or I thought that was funny, or that was clever, or whatever it is, or hey, I can now do this cool thing. So I want you to be able to share some feedback. And then the last part is an inspirational message. And that goes here, you can submit it. And this is for you. And here's the general description of it. It is a message to you. And you want to think about like how or what first inspired you to be interested in environmental issues. How did you choose to express yourself in this? What are some things that you could do in your future to carry this forward and keep you moving and motivated? Who's going to support you? Who's your community? And what are some words of advice you might have for yourself, okay? So take a look at that. It is, these are also each tailored within the projects themselves. So I'll just open up, I'll open a different one this time. So on the meeting, I showed the superhero. This one, I will show the ocean awareness. And if you open up this document, you scroll down, and this is what all of them have, just FYI. So they all have an introduction for that project. The project credit and timeline is in each one of the descriptions and outline. And then I also include the eight APES topics to kind of help you keep that in your mind. How does this tie in? Okay. And then here for this one, you know, it's like, how is using art meaningful to you? How has it made a difference? What values provide a touchstone when things get tough for you to stay in action? So each one of these is slightly tailored to the topic format you chose, but you get the gist. Okay, so that's it. That's the project. I hope you can have fun with this. I hope you find something that's interesting. I love this stuff. It blows my mind. It's why I teach. It's everything. And you are amazing and you inspire me and you are why I'm here. And like, go forth, enjoy, have some fun. You could team up with someone if you want to, but isn't this why we're all in it, right? So send me a message if you have any questions, and I'll talk to you soon.